Hello guys, welcome back. My name is Ash Moran and this is breaking news. Now we were sort of expecting it, but people were still 50-50 on it. Would he retire? Will he not retire? It looks like he was going to retire. Even Antonio Brown himself said he's still got more game in him. He's still got more in for another year or two. But guess what? So as you can see here, this is on eu.usatoday.com. Pittsburgh Steelers quarterback BenRoethlisberger retires from NFL after 18 seasons. Michael Middlehurst Schultz reported. So let's have a read. Nearly 2 weeks after a season-ending loss to the Kansas City Chiefs in the wildcard round of the AFC playoffs, BenRoethlisberger has confirmed that he and other reported that he has indicated was coming. His NFL career was over. The Pittsburgh Steelers quarterback finally announced his retirement Thursday in a social media post, bringing to an end an 18-year career, the longest of any quarterback who played with the only one team. That included two Super Bowl titles and six Pro Bowl selections. The time has come to clean up my locker, hang up my cleats, and continue to be all I can be to my wife and children. Roethlisberger said in the video, I retire from football, a truly grateful man. Roethlisberger has made no secret of his plans in recent weeks, saying he's led up to Week 17 matchup with Cleveland Browns, that the game was likely to be his last at Heinz Field. Steelers fans rained down chants of let's go Ben, thank you Ben, from pre-game until well after the 26-14 victory, after which he took a lap to thank those in the crowd who stayed. Fair play. Any season was extended, however, when the Steelers made an unlikely run to the playoffs after beating the Baltimore Ravens in the regular season finale and receiving help elsewhere in the AFC. Roethlisberger finishes his career ranked 5th in the NFL history with 64,088 passing yards and 8th in touchdown passes, 418. Jesus Christ, it's unreal. The number 11 overall pick out of Miami in the 2004 NFL draft behind fellow and massive mainly signal callers Eli Manning and Philip Rivers. Roethlisberger was pushed into action quickly as a rookie due to injuries and started in the third week of the campaign. He went on to win all 13 games of start of that season, claiming Offensive Rookie of the Year and pushing Pittsburgh to a 15-1 mark before it would fall in the AFC Championship game. The following season, Roethlisberger won the first Super Bowl when the Steelers defeated the Seattle Seahawks. He won his second title in 2008, authorizing one of the most storied moments in Super Bowl history when he found wide receiver San Antonio Holmes in the back of the end zone for a toe-tapping touchdown in the final minute. I remember that. In March 2010, Roethlisberger was accused of sexual assault by a 20-year-old college student at a Georgia bar. Prosecutors denied to file charges, but NFL Commissioner Roger Goodell suspended the quarterback under the league's personal conduct policy. An internal ban of 6 games was later reduced to 4. Roethlisberger faced a civil lawsuit in the previous July from a Nevada hotel employee who accused him of rape. The two settled in January 2012. After serving his suspension, Roethlisberger made another trip to the Super Bowl in 2010 season. But the Steelers fell to the Green Bay Packers and the quarterback will not reach the stage again for the rest of his career. So you can see, for everything you've done for the organization, the city and the game, thank you. After missing several games throughout his career due to injury, Roethlisberger would suffer his most serious ailment in 2019 when an elbow injury sustained him in Week 2 against the Seattle Seahawks with necessary season-ending surgery. He returned the following year and led Pittsburgh to an 11-0 start, but the Steelers would lose 4 of their final five regular season contests before falling in the wild card round to the Cleveland Browns. Roethlisberger accepted a pay cut to return to the Steelers in 2021, but his efficiency waned as he struggled to push the ball down the field and repeatedly settled for checkdowns. He posted the lowest yards per attempt, 6.2, of any season in his career, save for the injury-shortened 2019 campaign. Against the Chiefs, his 24 first-half passing yards presented the second lowest total of any game in his career. Pittsburgh now enters the off-season needing a new starting quarterback for the first time under coach Mike Tomlin and general manager Kevin Colbert, the latter of whom expects to retire after his year's draft, according to multiple reports. Mason Rudolph, who is under contract through 2022, has served as Roethlisberger's backup for the last 3 years, starting 10 games in that span. Dwayne Haskins is set to be restricted free agent. It's been an honor and a pleasure, Thompson said of Roethlisberger's career on Sunday night, and I don't have the words. And that's it. So, bit of a big one. Even though with his personal life, his personal grievances and personal stuff he had to deal with, but in total, what an incredible career. What an incredible career this guy's had, and he stayed with the same team regardless. You know, that's a, you know, Pittsburgh loves him. No doubt about it. What he's done is incredible. His career's been incredible. Two Super Bowls as well. You know what I mean? I think they're the highest. I think it's them and New England Patriots. Six Super Bowls each. Incredible. What a team, what a bloke. That's it on that. Leave your comments, guys. Tell me what you think. What's your historical moment from Ben? What do you think of the report? Let us know. Leave your comments down below. Thank you very much as well for the 58 subscribers. Really fortunate. I appreciate you guys subscribing. If you're new, subscribe. So I'll be doing more news throughout the week. More stuff coming out video-wise and so forth. So, yeah. Thank you very much for watching. And I'll see you guys on the next video.